There he goes on to second. It's a fly ball on the hit and run. The drop just inside the right field line. Goodman comes over, fields the ball. Sauter is held up at third, and Medlick goes on to second. A double for Medlick just inside the right field line. Going for a bad ball on the hit and run with Sauter racing to third. That ball drops perhaps 50 feet back to first base. So it's Medlick on second, Slaughter on third, and Big Johnny Mize comes up. Neil Schaffner, left-handed pitcher, formerly of the Boston League, used now generally in relief by the Red Sox, warming up in the bullpen. They're passing Johnny Mize. Here's the next pitch outside, ball two. Johnson goes outside again, ball three. Here's the fourth one, ball four. So Mize is purposely passed, but he Mize on first, Medlick on second, Slaughter on third, two out, the bases are loaded, and John Padgett, who is catching this game today, comes up, batting left-handed. Mike Gonzalez, coaching at third, Buzzy Wears, coaching at first, for the Cards. Johnson winds up, here's the pitch to Padgett, Padgett goes for it, the ground ball is short, it's picked up by Myers, who crosses the Ronnie Fry, forcing Mize at second. Grounding to shortstop Billy Myers, who crossed with Ronnie Fry, forcing Johnny Myers at second for the third out. Side is retired. No runs. Two hits. No errors. And the bases were left filled. Now we go to the last half of the first inning. Not much chance to give you any of the color, and as much as the game had already started by the time we came on the air. There's a crowd today that will number pretty close to 30,000 by the time it all gets in. There are some of the reserve seats that have not as yet been filled, but the tickets have been sold. And even if the folks don't show up who have the tickets, there's a crowd milling around the outside of Crosley Field trying to get in. Well, Kurt Davis goes out onto the mound, starts throwing experimentally with Mickey Owen, but it'll be Don Padgett who will catch this first game. The infield for the Cardinals made up of Johnny Mize at first, Stuart Martin at second, Jimmy Brown at short, John Gutteridge at third. The outfield, Joe Medlick at left, Kerry Moore in center, and Eno Slaughter in right field. The first three batters to come up for the Reds will be Werber, Fry, and Goodman. Benny Werber is playing in his 143rd game of the season, hitting .292, has been attacked 583 times, and has 169 hits. Eddie Werber, top of the plate. Patrick gives a sign to Kirk Davis. The right-hander winds up, and here's the pitch. Curve ball is hit, a high bouncing ball back of the mound, taken by Don Gutteridge. The ball is knocked out of his hand as he collides with Davis on the mound. Gutteridge is charged with an error. The ball was a high bounder hit in front of the plate, bounced high in the air, a little to the left of the mound. John Gutteridge, the third baseman, Jimmy Brown, the shortstop, and Kirk Davis all went for it. The ball was caught out of the air by Gutteridge, but he smashed into Kirk Davis and dropped the ball. And it's charged with an error. That brings up Lonnie Fry, playing his 121st game, batting .295, 137 hits, and 464 times the bat. Here's the first pitch to Fry. He bunts out in front of the mound. It's picked up by Kirk Davis, who throws the first, covered by Johnny Mize. Fry is out, and Werber takes second on the sacrifice. Fry sacrificing, throwing out Davis to Johnny Mize. Pitcher to the first baseman who covers. That brings up Ivel Disson, right fielder, left-handed batter. Playing his 120th game of the season, batting .325, 147 hits, and 453 times at bat. Werber on second. The stretch is by Kirk Davis. He looks back at second. Here's the pitch to Ivel Goodman. He swings and follows the first pitch back into the screen as he gets under it. Strike one. Warming up on the bullpen for the St. Louis Cards. It's Werber on second, no score on the game, last half of the first inning. One away, stretched by Kirk Davis. Here's the pitch to Goodman. Goodman goes for it, hits the fly ball out of left center field. Joe Medlick backs out, he's out of it, takes it for the second out. Goodman flying out to Medlick in left center field for the second out. brings up Frank McCormick, hitting in the cleanup spot, playing his 150th game. He's still looking for his 200th hit. The first hit he gets this afternoon will be his 200th. He's batting 328, has 199 hits in 607 times at bat. McCormick at the plate, bats right-handed, Werber on second, two outs. No score, last half of the first inning. John Patchett in the cross, gives the sign to Kirk Davis, who stretches, looks back a second. Here's the pitch to McCormick. He swings at a curve and misses for strike one. Jimmy Wilson coaching at first. Manager Bill McKechnie coaching at third for the Cincinnati Reds. Stretch again by Kirk Davis. Here's the pitch to Frank McCormick. A fastball. He hits it on the ground on George Sharp. It's picked up by Jimmy Brown, who gets it over to first to Johnny Myers for the third out. Side is retired. McCormick grounding out. Brown to Myers. Side retired. No run. No hit. One error. One runner is left. Well, there's one inning of the ball game out of the way with no score. Each team having a chance to score. The Cards perhaps having the better chance of the two. One error has been committed. Two hits. No hits so far off Kirk Davis. The sun is beginning to shine a little bit. Weather is more conducive to football, perhaps, today. That is in the shade, at least, than it is to baseball. Hardly cloudy overhead. Little blue sky beginning to show up here and there. This morning, very chilly here in Cincinnati. This afternoon, a little bit warmer. As we go to the top of the second inning with no score, it's Moore, Martin, and Davis, the first three batters to come up. Harry Moore will be the first batter. Comes up out of the dugout. The Reds dugout is to the left of home plate. The Cardinals dugout is to the right of home plate. The distance is, for those of you who are not familiar with this park, to left field at the foul line, about a 20-foot fence, and the distance is 328 feet. And a ball hit out there today will be hit right directly into the wind. To the left of the scoreboard, which is in left center field, the distance is 282 feet. To the right of the scoreboard, in right center field, in left center field, rather, is 383. To the right center field flagpole is 387 feet. To the right field line at the bleachers, 366. Terry Moore's up, that's right handed. The first pitch is high, ball one. One ball, no strike. Manager Ray Blake starting off with his ace pitcher, Kirk Davis. Wind up again by Thompson for fastball. It's missed it back at the plate, foul, and comes up into the screen. Now Barty comes back for it, but it's way out of his reach. The count is one ball, one strike. Umpire Larry Getz throws a new ball out to Bill Werber. The umpires are Larry Getz at first, Dave Pinelli at first, Larry Getz at the plate, rather. Dave Pinelli at first, Dick Campbell at second, and Dean Reardon at third. Johnson wind up. Here's the pitch to Moore. Moore goes for it. Lifts the foul to the left of the plate. Lombardi is coming back, but it's going back into the sand. Out of reach. Goes back some 10 rows back into the sand. One ball, two strikes to count. Top of the second, no score. New ball is thrown out by umpire Larry Getz to Bill Werber. Werber always returns the ball to the pitcher. By that I mean it. The ball is not thrown back to him by any other infielder. It's always given to Bill Werber. And then, back to the mound. Here's the windup. Here's the pitch to Moore. Inside. Ball two. The count is even up. Two balls and two strikes. Terry Moore is a right-handed batter. He's back at the plate again. Gene Thompson winds up. Here it is. Fast ball. It's hit on the ground. He broke his bat. On the ground is short. Picked up by Bill Myers. Gets it over to first to McCormick. He's out. Moore grounding out Myers to McCormick. One away. That brings up Stuart Martin. Rather slender built second baseman for the St. Louis Cards. One away. Thompson winds up. He throws a curveball. It's hit weakly on the ground and foul. Back of Buzzy Wears. It was over for it. The ball rolls up against one of the officers. And they have covers posted all along the stands this afternoon, and any player, or any fielder rather, any spectator who interferes with a fielder or player or a ball in play will be ejected. The next ball is hit on the ground to first. McCormick fields it, makes the out unassisted, although Gene Thompson is over there to take the throw if necessary. There have been one or two experiences this year where a ball in play has been grabbed by a spectator who wanted a souvenir of the game, and it has brought about some rather bad consequences. So the announcement has been frequently made of late here at Crosley Field that any spectator who interferes with a ball in play will be promptly ejected from the game. And it's rather surprising to see the effect that has on the spectators. They'll start for a ball and remember that and go right back to their seats as quickly as they can, leave it alone. Kurt Davis is a pretty fair hitter for a pitcher. Has been used a bit as a pinch hitter for the car. Here's the pitch to the right-handed batter. He pulled his swing as he started for an outside curve, and it's ball one. We're in the top of the second with no score. First game of the doubleheader. Johnson throws a fastball that misses the inside corner. It's ball two. Two balls, no strike. Johnson goes back to the rod and back. Here's the windup. Here's the next pitch. Fastball. He swings and fouls it into the dirt back of the plate. It rolls back to the sand. Or strike one. Two balls and one strike to count. Two off. Nobody on. Two balls. Goes into Gene Johnson. Kurt Davis in the meantime. Out of the batter's box. Now he steps back up again. Here's the windup. And here it is. Fastball is hit on the line. Out the left field. Myers jumps forward but can't get it. It's a hit. Throws out to Wally Berger who fields it. Berger gets it into second. It's a single for Kurt Davis. That is the third hit off Gene Johnson. Davis on first with a swing to the left. That brings up Jimmy Brown, who was thrown out by Gene Johnson just as he came on the air in the first inning. Johnson takes a stretch. Davis on first. Here's the pitch. Brown goes forward, hits the ground ball down to second. Ronnie Fry knocks it down and can't hang on to it. It's charged with an error. Davis on second. Brown is on first on Ronnie Fry's error. That puts Brown on first. Davis on second, two off, and brings up Don Gutteridge, who flied out to Wolfberger in left center field in the first inning, his first time up. Brown is on first and second, two off. Johnson ran into his trouble in the first inning with two off. Gutteridge bats right-handed. He's the third baseman for the Cards. Stretched by Johnson. And here's the pitch. It's a fly ball to the right of the plate. Ernie Lombardi goes after it, circles around under it, and takes it for the final out. Gutteridge fouling out to Ernie Lombardi, just to the right of the plate. Side retired. No run. One hit, one error, and two runners for that. Now we go to the last half of the second inning of this first game of the doubleheader. Both games of which we're planning to broadcast this afternoon. The first three batters will be Lombardi, Kraft, and Berger. Top coat in evidence this afternoon. Sweaters and jackets. Not very many people in shirt sleeves out there in the right field bleachers where the sun is beginning to bear down. Just a mob of humanity, and they are sitting pretty much in their shirt sleeves. But in the grandstand themselves, out of the protection of the, or out of the benefit rather of the sun, you find regular coats, sweaters, leather jackets, and things of that sort, pretty much enough. Ernie Lombardi coming up for the first time in the game. He bats right-handed, is playing in his 129th game of the season. At the batting average, rather surprisingly low for Big Rom, who last year was leading the National League and went on to win the National League batting crown, batting 286 at the present time, 126 and hits in 441 times to bat. Davis winds up. Here it is. The fly ball going out toward right field. Sauter is going for it fast. He can't get it. It bounces off the right field bleacher screen. Lombardi goes on to second and pulls up at second with a double. For Lombardi, that's his 26th double of the season. For those of you who are not familiar with Crosley Field, may I explain that in all three fields, left, center, and right field, there is an elevated terrace that in left field moves up toward the wall, in center field moves up toward the wall, and in right field moves up toward the bleachers. A little fence, possibly 2.5 to 3 feet high, all the way across the front of the right field bleachers, and then there's a screen part way up. Any ball hit into that screen is in play. Any ball hit over the screen goes for a home run. Somebody on second. Harry Kraft is up. Right into batter, center fielder. Kraft hitting 258 at the present time. Here's the pitch to Kraft. Outside, ball one. Harry is playing his 130th game of the season. Batting average of 258, made up of 125 hits in 485 times at bat. Lombardi on second. Infield not bothering much with him. Here's the next pitch to Kraft with the curveball. Kraft swings and misses for strike one. Clyde Down and Bob Bowman, a left-hander and right-hander respectively, are warming up in the right. right field bullpen. Ball to St. Louis Cards. Davis gets the sign for John Padgett. Lombardi on second. Here's the next pitch to Harry Crapp. Curveball. He started for it. Didn't pull his swing in time, and it's called a strike. One ball, two strikes to count. Harry tried to check his swing on that. That's double by Lombardi, by the way. The first hit off Kurt Davis. In this ballgame. Stretch by Davis. Here's the pitch to Harry Crapp. Curveball misses the outside corner, and it evens the count. At two balls and two strikes. No scores. Last half of the second. First game of the doubleheader. Lombardi taking his lead off second. Davis looks back there. No play is being made. Here's the pitch to Ryan Clyde in the left field. They hit. Rolls off to Joe Medlick. Medlick feels it, fires it in. Lombardi is held at third. Harry Crabb. Singling to left. Lombardi taking third. That brings up Wally Burger. Wally playing his 93rd game of the season, batting 254, has 79 hits and 311 times at bat. Little conference offer on the mound around Kurt Davis. Wally's been hitting very well of late, however. Pulled his batting average up considerably. He's batting along in the 320s and low 330s most of the season. And the last 3 weeks, he's pulled his batting average up to 254. Runners on first and third. No score in the game. Kurt Davis puts into Don Padgett, gets the sign. There's the stretch by Davis. Here's the pitch. The high pop fly. Infield, back of the mound. Little to the left of it. Jimmy Brown follows it in and takes it almost on the mound. The wind puts that ball in. Berger popping out to shortstop Jimmy Brown. That brings up Billy Myers playing his 147th game of the season. Batting average of 280. That's made up of 138 hits in 492 times at bat. He's batting right-handed. It's Babbitt on first. Lombardi on third. One away. Taking his time while giving the sign to Kurt Davis, the right-hander. Still can't take a windup on an open base in second. There's the stretch. Here's the pitch to Bill Myers. Myers puts a high fly out toward left field. Medlick goes back to the fence. It's over the fence. A home run for Billy Myers. Johnny Mize is not holding him to first. Here's the curveball breaks across the plate. Ball, strike one call. One ball and one strike. Press box full of riding celebrities this afternoon. Baseball riders from all over the country are here for this series. Davis takes a stretch again. Here's the next pitch to Bill Weber. The curveball is lifted into the infield, a little to the right of the plate. It's going foul, and Don Padgett takes it. Lifted out in front of the plate a little bit. The wind got a hold of it, threw it over the foul line, and was taken some 15 or 20 feet to the right of the plate by Don Padgett. Weber fouling out to the catcher. On the second out, that brings up Ronnie Fry for the second time in the game. In the first inning, his first time up, he sacrificed and thrown out David Semai. Gene Thompson on first, two up. Last of the second, the score, Cincinnati 3. St. Louis Cards, nothing. Three pitches warming up out there now. Here's the pitch to Fry, outside and high, all one. Davis takes his stretch. Here comes the pitch to Fry. Strike one call. Knee high on the outside corner, and the count is even. One ball and one strike. Thompson leads off first. Davis stretches. Here's the pitch to Ronnie Fry. He goes for it. It's a line drive out into right field. It's good for a base hit. It's fielded by Sauter. Thompson stops at second. A single for Fry. A single to right. Gonzalez comes out and calls in five counts. At the end of Kirk Davis. Davis having worked one and two-thirds innings. He has allowed five hits, has walked none, has struck out none, runs allowed so far, three, and if Brian Thompson score, they will be charged against the record of Kirk Davis. S-H-O-U-M. John comes in the second inning with two out and pitches to Griffin. Well, the turn of events so far has been a little bit on the surprising side. It was expected that this would be a pretty close battle and not have anything quite as drastic as a home run but two on occur as early in the ball game as this. This is the first game of the doubleheader with the Cincinnati Reds leading by the score of 3-0. Five count is the second pitcher to be used. He's a left-hander. Kirk Davis is given a nice hand by the Cincinnati spectators as he walks out of the game, goes down the runway through the left field stands back to the clubhouse. And Dean Thompson has called for his jacket, which he has put on. Body game Bowman now warming up in the bullpen. It's two out. Goodman flied out to Medley in the first inning, his first time up. Runners on first and second. Two out. Badgett gives the sign to Clyde Town. The softball throws a fastball high. Ball one. One ball, no strike to count. Again by John. Here's the next pitch to Goody. Fast ball high. Ball two. Two balls and no strikes. Let's have runners on first and second. And here it is. Fast ball low and outside. Ball three. The count. John rubbing up the ball before pitching again, taking a little stroll for himself. Bonnie Warnke is now left alone out there in the bullpen to warm up. Three balls, no strikes to count. It's Fry on first, Thompson on second, two up. Here's the next pitch. Strike one call. Crossfire across the plate. Three and one. The ball got away out there as Warnke was warming up. Went into fair territory in the right field area and has been retrieved. Play is resumed. Three balls, one strike to count. Here's the next pitch to Goodman. Goodman swings and fouls it up on top of the grandstand roof. Back of third base. The ball dropped off somebody's hand up there, but all the way down into the field seat. Back of third base. The new right field position here is complete. Back to Crosley Field once again to resume the broadcast of the doubleheader this afternoon between the St. Louis Cards and the Cincinnati Reds. It's now possible to complete the record of Kirk Davis and charge him with three runs. Slaughter, Hendrick, and Mize are the first three batters to come up. Thompson in the top of the third. The announcement has just been made in the public address system. The single games will be played here tomorrow and on Thursday. Those are the last two games of the season, by the way, at Crosley Field for the Cincinnati Reds. They finished their season out at Pittsburgh. A single game Friday, a single game Saturday, and a single game on Sunday. Thompson still limbering up with Ernie Lombardi. He's a little slow coming out of the dugout. Place is absolutely packed this afternoon. Those of you who have not been in Crosley Field in some time, they have built a new upper right field pavilion and a new upper left field pavilion with an estimated increase in the seating capacity of approximately 3,100. The right field pavilion is all complete and today is just jam-packed. The left field pavilion is perhaps half completed and they're letting people in there now. The right fielder is up. He singled to center in the first inning. Here's the pitch to him. He lets the fly ball out into short center field. Billy Myers, Lonnie Fry going back. Lonnie goes back and pitches. Back and second base, a beautiful running catch going away. Slaughter popping out to Lonnie Fry back in short center field for the first out. That brings up Joe Medley, who hit it a bad ball in the first inning on the hit and run. As Slaughter lit out for second, he reached out for a wide pitch and lifted a fly just inside the right field line. Good for two bases. The first pitch, he swings, hit the line drive into center field. It's good for a base hit. Goes out there to Harry Kraft, who feels it, gets it back into second. It's a single for Joe Medley. That is his second hit of the game. A single to center, and that's hit number four off Gene Thompson. Johnny Mize coming up. Mize was purposely passed in the first inning, his first time up. It's Medley on first, one away. Thompson stretches. McCormick plays back from the base. Here's the pitch to Mize. Fastball high and inside. Ball one. Sun shining quite brightly now, although the sky is just a little bit hazy. Again, Thompson stretches. Here's the pitch to Mize. Mize started his swing, pulled it on the low inside pitch. For ball two. The count is two balls and no strikes. One away. Medley on first. Again, the stretch by Gene Thompson. Here's the pitch to Johnny Mize. Mize hit the line drive down the right field line. It's good for a base hit. Ivan Goodman comes over, intercepts it, gets it in quickly. Medley stops at third. Mize goes on to second with a double. A double to right. That brings up Don Padgett. Padgett hit into a force play in the first inning, his first time up. Don is tying his shoelaces. He comes up, looks down to the dugout. Manager Ray Blades apparently calling something out, and Fuzzy Wears, who's coaching at first, calls something to him. Infield plays in. They're going to pass Don Padgett. First pitch is outside. Here's the next one. Outside, ball two. Ball three. And here's the next one. Ball four. Two men have been perfect. tremendously fast. That makes possible a force play at any base. Brings up Terry Moore. Moore was thrown out by Billy Myers in the second inning. There's one out. Base is filled. Bill Joffner starts warming up again in the bullpen for the Cincinnati Reds. He's a left-hander. Moore right into batters at the plate. Base is loaded. One out. Johnson winds up. And here it is. Curveball inside. Ball one. One ball. No strike. Again, Bob Bowman joins Ron Warnicki in warming up in the right field bullpen. Johnson winds up again, throws a fastball, he swings and misses for strike one. One ball and one strike. Neither manager will spare any players in this series. It's now and ever for both of them. One ball, one strike. Johnson winding up, throws high, ball two. Two balls and one strike is the count. Sun going under a cloud. Bases filled. Terry Moore is the batter. Thompson winds up. Here's the pitch. Outside. Ball three. Three balls and one strike. Three and one the count. Thompson takes his windup. And here it is. Inside. Ball four. Moore walks, forcing in a run. Hedrick scores from third. Myers moves to third. Padgett on second. And that's walk number three, given up by Gene Johnson. Two intentional and one unintentional. Johnson is asked for a new ball. That ball is thrown out of the game by umpire Larry Getz. That brings up Stuart Martin, who grounded off McCormick on assisted back in the second inning. Score, Cincinnati three, St. Louis Cards one in the top of the third. Thompson winds up. Here's the pitch. Martin swings, fouls it back into the screen for strike one. Somebody throws the new ball out to Bill Werber. Werber up to the hip and throws it to Gene Thompson. Hugh Martin, left-handed batter. Watches Thompson wind up. And here's the pitch. Hit the line drive foul out into the right field seat in front of the right field pavilion. Strike two. No balls and two strikes. One out, one run in. Johnson winds up again, throws a fastball. It's high, ball one. One ball and two strikes is the count. Gene Thompson winds up. Here it is. High and inside, ball two, and the count is even. Two balls and two strikes. Johnny goes back to the Rosin bag. Back up on the hill again. My body gets the sign. Winds up. Here it is. Curveball doesn't break quite enough. Misses the outside corner of the plate. Ball three. Three balls. Two strikes. That brings the big one up to Stuart Martin. Three and two. Here's Thompson. Wind up. And here it is. Ground ball down toward first. McCormick fields it. Throws to the plate to Lombardi, and he's forced. Johnny Mize is forced at the plate. The play, McCormick to Lombardi. Base is still filled. Padgett on third. Moore on second. Martin on first. That brings up Johnny Hop, H-O-double-P. Johnny Hop, who had the promise at one time of being a great outfielder, but his arm went bad on him. He's from the Rochester Red Wings of the International League. Very fast. He's hitting for Clyde Chow. H-O-double-P, Johnny Hop. Johnny Hop. Bases filled. He bats left-handed. Here's the windup by Thompson. Here's the pitch to Hop. He swings the first pitch. Fouls it back to the screen for strike one. This Johnny Hop is about as fast a man on base as you'll ever see. Martin on first. Moore on second. Padgett on third. Here's the windup again by Gene Thompson. Here's the pitch. Strike two. Called. A perfect curve across the plate. Way's high. 3, St. Louis Cards 1. We're at the top of the third. Here's the lineup by Johnson, and the fast curve misses outside, a little high for ball one. One ball and two strikes. Johnson drops the route and back of him. Wind up. Here it is. Low and inside, ball two. Away from Lombardi, rolled out in front of the plate. Bond goes up, picks it up, hands it to Johnson, who came in for it. And umpire Larry gets in the meantime, dusting off the plate. Two balls, two strikes to count. Again, Johnson goes back to the rod bag. Bases filled. Here's the windup. Here it is.
Look it out. Johnny Hop struck out swinging with the bases filled. Side retired with one run.
No error. The bases were left filled. So now we go to the last half of the third inning with the score Cincinnati 3, St. Louis Cards 1. Bill McKechnie stops Gene Johnson on his way back to the dugout, gives him a little fatherly advice. You can almost see him as he left Gene. With the palm of his hand, he sort of made a gesture towards Gene as if to say, you're doing well in there, kid. Just keep it up. McCormick, Lombardi, and Kraft. Now the first three batters to come up as we go to the last half of the third inning of this first game of the doubleheader. The broadcast direct from Crosley Field in Cincinnati. Bob Bowman, B-O-W-M-A-N. Third pitcher to be used by the car. He's a right-handed pitcher. Kurt Davis's pitching record then for this game is a third of an inning and nothing else. He pitched to Ivor Goodman.
Single to left in the second inning.
ball, Terry off to one side, tells him what to do. Ron Warnicki warming up again in the bullpen. Ball to Cars. It's Lombardi on first, McCormick on third. Nobody down. Coleman gets the sign. No chance for a windup with an open base at second. Here's the pitch to Kraft. Fastball is high. Ball one. One ball, no strike. It's a high pop fly going out into short left field, just back to shortstop position. Jimmy Brown is there for it. Takes it on the base pass as the wind pushes it back in. Kraft popping out to Jimmy Brown for the first stop. That brings up Wally Berger, who also popped out to shortstop in the second inning, his first time up. One away. Berger at the plate. Runners on first and third. Here's the pitch. Foul coming back up toward the broadcasting booth. We're up pretty high here, however. We're on the roof of the second deck. Very seldom a foul ball gets up this high. Berger back at the plate. Stretched by Bob Pullman. Here's the pitch. High inside. Ball two. Or ball one, rather. One ball and one strike. Pullman goes into the roster bag. Back up on the mound. Bob Weiland has now gone out to the bullpen to warm up. Here's the next pitch. Fastball is high. Ball two and the count. Two balls and one strike. Berger stands there just waiting. Coleman takes quite a bit of time now. Drops that ball in the palms of his hands. Get all the sheen off the high so the ball will slip out of his fingers. He stretches. Here's the pitch to Berger. Berger lifts the line drive foul into the left field position. Count is 2-2. Two balls and two strikes. Joe Medwick playing almost back to the left field wall, playing halfway up the terrace. Baller playing a little short, right center, center right field. They're playing Berger, of course, for a left field hitter, a full hitter. There's the stretch. And here's the pitch to Berger. Foul. He swung over the top of it. Hit it off the foot of umpire Larry Getz. It bounced up against the Cincinnati bat boy, who was leaning right alongside of Billy Myers. Was waiting his next turn at bat. Now the main 2-2. This moment's pretty quick for a little follow. Lombardi on first. McCormick on third. One out. Here's the pitch to Berger. Down ball down the third baseline. His foul rolls out to the Cincinnati bullpen. Out there where Hank Gowdy is, moniker Molly Gervais. He dies a thousand deaths out there, Hank does, during the course of these ball games. Two and two the count. Coleman again takes the stretch. Here's the pitch to Wally Berger. It's a line drive going out toward left field. It's timed up. Joe Medwick comes in, takes it. There's the break for the plate by McCormick. A throw into Padgett, and he's out. A perfect throw from Medwick to the plate, and McCormick is out for the third out. That's a nice play by Joe Medwick. Side retired, no run. Two hits. Order will come up for the Cards as we go to the first half of the fourth inning. Joe Medwick is given a hand for that perfect strike he threw to the plate to retire McCormick as McCormick tried to score after the catch. Bowman, Gutteridge, and Slaughter will be the first, or Brown rather, Gutteridge and Slaughter will be the first three batters to come up in the top of the fourth. Gene Thompson so far has one strikeout, has walked three, two intentionally, and one unintentionally. Each team has committed one error so far. Here's that announcement I told you about earlier. Any person interfering with the ball in play will be ejected from the park. That means that it overthrows the base and the ball goes back toward the sand. Any spectator who reaches over and picks up that ball, because of course it's in play, will be invited to leave. That ball is good on the outside corner, knee high, for a strike call. They count one ball, one strike. Top of the fourth. Score Cincinnati 3. They do his cards one. Here's the lineup again by Thompson. Here's the pitch. Brown checks his swing. It's low. Ball two. Two balls, one strike. Thompson on the mound again. Right-hander winds up. He throws a fastball. It's on the ground for a second. Bonnie Fry fields it. Takes it out of his glove. Throws to McCormick. Brown is out. Bonnie outside of McCormick. That brings up Don Gutteridge. Gutteridge, twice up, no hit. Wide out to Berger and left-hander in the first. Fouled out to third in the second. Thompson, here's the first pitch. The fastball hit the line out in the center field. It drops in there for a hit. It's fielded on the second hop by Harry Kraft, who gets it back into second. A single to center for Don Gutter. That's hit number six off Dean Johnson. Enos Baller coming up. Single to center in the first. And popped out to Lonnie Fry. Back up second in the third. Gutter leads off and then is brought back in a hurry as the throw from Thompson. McCormick almost picked him off base, and McCormick practically fell over Gutteridge, trying to retain his own balance as he was going for that throw. Gutteridge leads off. Here's the pitch. Strike one call, well across the plate. No balls, one strike. Enos Slaughter is up for the first time in the game. There's the stretch again by Thompson. Gutteridge leads off. Here's the pitch. Ground ball down towards short. Myers up with it, over to Fry. Doesn't bother to throw as Gutteridge takes him out of the play at second. That is a force play. Carter gets away very fast at the plate. Carter on first of the field, of course. The play, Myers to Fry. Hard baseball will be played in this series. The blue chips are down if they ever were down. That brings up Joe Medwick, 2-for-2, a double to right in the first, a single to center in the third. Carter leads off. Here's the pitch. Again by Gene Thompson. Quick throw to first, and Slaughter dives back. He's up on his feet again. Thompson stretches. Again, Slaughter leads off. Here's the pitch. Curveball is hit over McCormick's head and lands foul on the right field line by about 3 feet. Hadley got a very small piece of that ball. He hit it up on the handle of the bat. Swung late at it. And just sort of pumped it out over McCormick's head. And it curved foul. That's just the second strike. Balls, two strikes. Slaughter is off to a great start on that. Returns to first. Joe Medwick back at the plate again. Set by Thompson. Slaughter again leads off. Here's the pitch. Foul back into the screen. Out of the same. New ball is thrown out to Bill Weber and returned to Thompson. Quick throw to first base again forces Slaughter to dive into the base. Thompson just whirled around and fired that ball over to Frank McCormick, and Slaughter dove back in, hands extended. No balls, two strikes is the count on Joe Medwick. McCormick and Thompson had a little huddle. Now they're both in their respective positions. Here's the pitch to Medwick. The ground ball right to the box. Second, bounces off the base, second for Myers, Myers to McCormick. There's a close play, and Medwick doesn't like it at all. Medwick took off his hat. He's having a strong argument out there with umpire Dave Finelli. Cap in hand, he's slapping his thigh with it. He didn't like that. That ball, the cue that he hit, was hit right through the box, went out into second base position, and hit second base. Bounced off at an angle, spoiling a force play, and Myers had to pick it out of the air in a hurry and fire it over to first. Umpire Dean Clearton continues the discussion there with Joe Medwick. Medwick is out. Myers to McCormick. Side retired. No run. One hit. acting as a peacemaker on that. Probably went over to Joe and said, now, Joe, we're going to give you a little attitude on this, more than we probably would normally. But this is an important series. Curb that temper of yours, because we don't want to have to kick you out of the game. This is reminiscent of the World Series days when Joe Medrick was the center of a group for all.
Of the year.
looking for that now for 3 days. We expected it Saturday. We expected it Sunday. And it didn't show up. Joe Medrick just has a little partying shot. And there he gets. And as the fans get on him, he takes off his cap in a very gracious gesture and parades down the dugout that way. It's Johnny Mize, John Padgett, and Terry Moore, the first three batters to come up in the top of the fifth inning. With the score, Cincinnati 3, the St. Louis Cards 1. Gene Thompson, limbering up with Ernie Lombardi. Red scoring all three runs in the second inning off Kirk Davis. Lombardi double to right, McCormick, or Kraft rather, single to left. Lombardi stopping at third, and then with runners on first and third, popped out to Brown, and Myers hit a home run that hit on top of the left center field wall and bounced out. Those are the three runs for all the Cincinnati Reds. Cardinals got their scoring in the third inning. That was one out, Medrick singles, Myers double to right, Padgett purposely passed, and then Moore walked the fourth in a run. Thompson winds up, and here's the pitch. That ball misses the outside corner of the plate. Mize up twice, perfectly passed in the first, double to right. In the third is the next pitch. Foul up into the upper left field pavilion. That pavilion, by the way, is pretty well packed, despite the fact that only half the seats are in there. Of course, they have all the superstructure worked up. All the flat metal has been laid on which the seats are usually fastened. Here's the windup. Here's the pitch to Mize. Low curve is low, ball two. Pretty fair pitch there by Gene Thompson, but it missed. One strike to count. Here's the lineup. Here's the pitch to Mize. Strike two call. The fastball way high in the outside corner. Johnny Mize protesting in a small way to umpire Larry Getz. Count is even up. 2-2. Johnson winds up. Here's the pitch. Ground ball down towards first. He's second by McCormick in fair territory. And McCormick steps on first for an unassisted out. Johnny Mize is needing another to run it out. Mize is making motions with his pipe in the dirt to show that ball was at least 3 feet foul in his estimation. Newspapers and documents ought to get a shot at that argument. In short life, however, Johnny turns on his heel, goes back to the dugout. Ray Blade stopped Johnny on the way in. Ray saunters out to the plate, has a little conference with umpire Larry Getz. Was called fair by both umpire Larry Getz at the plate and Dave Finelli at first. So there's one out. John Padgett coming up. It's been up twice, no hit. Hit into a fourth play in the first, but perfectly passed in the third. Thompson lined up. Here's a pitch. The curveball is low and outside. Ball one. Done again, Johnny Friday. We're in the top of the fifth. Thompson winds up. There's a pitch to Padgett. He swings, hits the ground ball down toward second. It's taken by Ronnie Fry. Fry gets to the first of McCormick. Padgett is out. Out Fry to McCormick for the second out. That brings up Terry Moore. Moore has been up twice in this ballgame, has no hit. Once officially, he's been up. He was thrown off by Billy Myers in the second and walked in the third. Terry Moore, right into batter, is up at the plate. Thompson winds up. And here it is, a curveball across the plate, knee high for strike one call. Up again. Here's the pitch to Terry Moore. It's a fastball that just misses the outside corner and is a little low. One ball and one strike. Two up. Nobody on. Thompson winds up again. Here's the pitch. Oh, and inside. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. Moore, Cincinnati 3. St. Louis 1. For you late tuners in. Dean Thompson winds up. Throws a fastball that is high and it's ball three. Intentionally, and two, Terry Moore. up. Twice up, no hits. That's left-handed. Late man in the batting order. Here's a pitch to him. He hits a high fly. Out towards right field. Ivo Goodman goes back at the foot of the terrace. Stuff right there to the track. He's out of it and takes it for the third out. Two margins flying out to Goodman in right field. Side retired. No runs. No hits. No errors. One runner is left. So now we go to the last half of the fifth inning. Goodman and McCormick, the first three batters to come up. Sam gives Gene Thompson a good hand as he comes down into the dugout. The Cincinnati dugout to the left. The St. Louis Cardinal dugout to the right. And boy, this place is really packed. Official tennis in the crowd won't be given out until sometime during the second game, but it'll be up. I would say offhand, it'll be up in the neighborhood of 31 or 32,000, perhaps even higher than that. There are no field seats, however, today. No ground rules due to the fact that there's an overflow crowd in the park. The park is entirely free of spectators, but they're just jammed into the regular stands. Standing up back in the aisles, looks to be standing up four and five deep. A new pavilion quarters, upper left field and upper right field pavilion, which has just been erected in the last month and a half or so, here at Crosley Field, are also well jammed. They've even spilled out up under the grandstand roof. Ronnie Fye is up for the third time in the game. A perfect day so far, a sacrifice in the first and a single in the second. He bats left-handed. We're in the last half of the fifth inning. Bob Bowman winds up. There's a pitch to Fye. Outside and high. Ball one. Fye made a gesture as if he was going to bunt. Don Cutter is coming into the edge of the infield grass. Bowman winds up again. Here's a pitch to Ronnie Fye. Fastball is high. Ball two. Two balls and no strikes. Wind up again by Bowman. Here's the next pitch. High. Ball three. 3-0 is the count. Activity in the bullpen has ceased. Three balls, no strikes. Bowman winding up. Here's a pitch to Ronnie Fye. High and inside. Ball four. Ronnie Fye walks. He's the first man to be walked this afternoon by any of the three St. Louis pitchers. Again, for you late tuners in, Kurt Davis started this ball game and yielded five hits and three runs. Taken out with two out in the second inning. Fye Chong came in, pitched to one man, and then Chong gave way to a pinch hitter, and Bowman has pitched since that time. Johnny Mize has moved into guard the inside corner. Bob Warnicki starts warming up in the bullpen, so does Bob Wyman. All the cards. Goodman at the plate has been up twice, has fired out the metric both times. There's the stretch. Quick throw over to first, and had that throw been lower, they would have had Ronnie Fye. That throw was high by Bowman. Had the throw been down to the base, Fye would have been out, because Bowman outguessed him on the motion. Fye was starting to increase his lead as the ball was thrown. Fye dove back head first. He's now shaking the dirt out of his uniform. There's the stretch. Here's the pitch. A bunt down for third. Picked up by Don Gutteridge. Gutteridge throws to first. Johnny Mize and Goodman is out. The sacrifice is dancing by the second. Goodman going out, sacrificing. Gutteridge to Mize. Fye taking second on the play. Frank McCormick coming up. McCormick grounded out short on the first. Single to left. In the third. Hit a line drive over the head of Timmy Brown. Started off in the third. There's the stretch. Here's the pitch to McCormick. Fastball is good on the outside corner, better high for strike one call. High eases away from second. Bowman's hand over his head to his waist. He throws. McCormick passes out with a line drive to center. Terry Moore takes it. Hardly had to move for it. Ball was well hit, but right at Terry Moore. Two out. That brings up Ernie Lombardi, who has 2-for-2. A double to right in the second, a single to right in the third. Newspaper photographers all over the place this afternoon.
him up there near second, watching the proceedings, hands on his hips. And there's the fourth one. Ball four. Goes Lombardi on first, Fry on second, two out, and Harry Kraft comes up. Harry has one hit in two times with that. He's singled left in the second, popped out to Jimmy Brown, the shortstop, in the third. He bats right-handed. Unable to take a windup on an open base at third. There's the stretch by Bowman. He looks back at second. Here's the pitch to Harry Kraft. Kraft swings and misses for strike one. Swing at that high hard one. That's the one Harry likes, that fastball. Bowman stretching again. Again, looks back at second. Here's the pitch. The curveball lifted high in the air out toward right field. Daughter starts going back for him. The wind gets out of it and catches it back on the terrace. He almost suggests that. He started in for it. Suddenly realized that the wind was getting a hold of it and had to turn around and go back. He took it, however. Kraft flying out to Slaughter, part way up the terrace in front of the right field bleachers. Side is retired. No run. No hits. No errors. And two runners are out. Now we go to the top of the sixth inning. Hit Bowman or someone to hit for him. Captain Martin, captain of the team, comes out to talk with umpire Eric Getz, possibly telling who's going to bat for Bowman, if anybody.
Try to take Fry out of that play.
Cutters, Donnie, going to Myers. Myers to Fry. Fry to McCormick. Double play. Side retired. No run. No hit. No error. And no one is left. Well, for the Reds this season, that's the 164th completed double play. Now the team change sides. We go to the last half of the sixth inning. The score is 3-1 in favor of the Cincinnati Reds. Berger, Myers, and Thompson are the first three batters to come up. Von Warnicke for St. Louis. Warnicke in the sixth inning.
There's a stretch. Here comes the pitch. Strike one called.
Cutter's had that analyzed perfectly, as Thompson did. Struck up his bat straight away. The fastball in the outside corner.
Florida, Ed Hendricks and Mize are the first three batters to come up. As we go to the top of the seventh, the score is Cincinnati 3, the St. Louis Cards 1. Two games this afternoon. Here's the first pitch. It's across the plate in the outside corner. Good for a strike call. Slaughter, one hit in three times. The bat is the next pitch. Strike two call in the outside corner. Nothing to do with the count. Thompson winds up again. It's outside. All one. One ball, two strikes. Thompson winds up again as the next pitch. High, ball two, and the count is even up, two and two. Call to batting left hand. Two and two. Here comes the lineup. Here it is. The high, top fly, back up third base. Bill Weber goes over for it. He lost it in the sun, apparently, and that's what Lombardi to take, and as a result, nobody took it. He started that point. It wasn't necessary. Of course, that ball was fighting a breeze all the way out there. Rather of a strong one, too. Count is 2-2. Ball back in the plate again. Johnson gets the sign. Winds up. And here it is. That ball is fouled back up into the upper deck. Misses the screen. Goes in over under the rafters. Remains 2-2. Your ball is thrown in to Gene Thompson. Gene winds up. Here's the pitch to Sauter. He swings and strikes out. Sauter striking out swinging, so that error of omission to put up the third base on that foul ball did no harm. That is the second strikeout for Gene Thompson. That brings up Joe Medley. Medley is given a free fair going over. Medlick is hit on the ground down the first baseline, pass first, out into right field, is thrown into the infield by Goodman, and Medlick pulls up a second with a double. A double to right. That brings up Johnny Mize. Mize has been up three times in the game. It's purposely passed in the first inning. Double to right in the third. And was thrown out in the corner, got assisted in the fifth. Outfield plays around. Playing Mize as a full hitter. Here's the pitch to Johnny Mize. Low, ball one. One ball, no strike. That gives Medley 3-for-4 so far this afternoon. Two doubles and a single. Hit the ground ball foul to the right of the plate. Rolls over to the stand. And the count is 2-2. Two balls and two strikes. All these balls are brought out to umpire Larry Kipp. Two balls, two strikes to count. As we count second, one away. Top of the seventh. Stretch by Thompson. And here it is. Foul back against the screen. Count is two balls, two strikes. No Johnson now warming up again for the Reds. Chicago Pittsburgh game this afternoon been called off because of rain. Here's Thompson's stretch. Here's the pitch to Johnny Mize. Ground ball foul. Back up first base. Johnson's up against the shoulder of some copper and they're leaning over the little barrier, the field seat. Thought it suspended. Spectators. Down there, got that ball. Two balls, two strikes to the count. Thompson drops the new ball. There's the stretch. Quick throw to second. Medley was back in time, however, as Billy Myers makes around back of Medley. Thompson whirled around. through.
Bradley goes back into the base. Joel leads off. There's the stretch. There it is. It's a curveball. Misses outside and low. Ball three. Three balls and two strikes. 3-2 is the count. Johnny Mize, big fellow, first baseman for the Cubs, stands there at the plate waiting. Here comes the pitch. He lifts the foul back up into the upper stand. Now it catches the corner of the screen. Sigmund still coming up to Johnny Mize. Thompson ready. Mize back at the plate again. Joe Medley starts to lead off second. Here's the pitch. It's a high fly, way up high in the air, out of the short right field. Fry goes back. Goodman comes in. Goodman calls for it. Takes it for the out. Johnny Mize hitting a little under that, lifting it very high to Goodman. In short right field, as Goodman came in, Fry went out. Pretty called for it all the way in. Five of an half. Two out. That brings up Don Padgett. Padgett, three times up, no hit. Hit into a fourth play in the first, purposely passed in the third, hit into another fourth play in the fifth. I don't know about he's out there talking things over with Dean Thompson. Four, Cincinnati, three, St. Louis Cards, one. The outside corner of the plate. It's ball two. Two balls and no strikes. Capacity out. house out here this afternoon. They couldn't get many more people in Crosley Field right now with a shoehorn. Here's the Warnicky lineup. There's a pitch to five swing. Hit the line drive into right center that drops in there for a base hit. Defeated by Terry Moore, the center fielder in right center field. It's a single for Lonnie Farr. Ivo Goodman coming up. Goody up for the fourth time in the ballgame. Fried out the Medlick and left center in both the first and second innings, then sacrificed in the fifth. Ryan first. Goodman batting left-handed, stands deep in the batter's box. Here's the pitch to Goodman. Goodman swings, hits a high foul back up third base. John Frederick races over toward the stands and going about 8 or 10 rows back in. Out of reach. Simply a high and loud foul. No balls, one strike to count. Sun again shining brightly and warmly. Goodman back at the plate. There's a rhythmic clapping starting up down below. The fans want to see a rally get underway. Again, fire leads off. Here's the pitch to Goodman. He takes it outside. Ball one. Choking up his bat, bringing in both Ron Warnicky and Don Cutteridge pass. One ball, one strike to count. Cutteridge backs up to the edge of the infield grass. Stays about 2 feet this side of the skin part of the third base area. Pulls in a little nearer. Warnicky stretches. Goodman looks down to third to see whether the front sign is on or not. Leads off. Here's the pitch. Goodman swings at the ground ball. It's taken by Warnicky. Warnicky throws to second. Brown over to first to Johnny Myers, and it's turned into a fast double play. Goodman grounding to Warnicky, who jumped high to get that ball on the bounce. Got it to Brown, who covered second. Brown to Myers. That's the second double play into which the Reds have hit this afternoon. That brings up Frank McCormick. An even 200 hits for the season. Packed up for the fourth time in the game. Thrown out by shortstop Brown in the first, single to left in the third, lined out to Terry Moore, et cetera, in the fifth. Warnicky winds up. Here's the pitch, fast ball, strike one call. Knee high on the outside corner. Brooklyn 5, New York nothing at the end of 3. Again, the windup by Warnicky. Here's the next pitch. Misses outside, ball one. One ball, one strike. Four umpires for the series. Barry Getz at the plate. Dave Pennelly at third. Nick Campbell at second. And Dean Dreher. Here's the lineup. Here's the next pitch to McCormick. A slow curve inside. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. Two balls, one strike, two up. Nobody on. Last to the seventh. Wind up by Warnicky. Here's the pitch. Fast ball just misses outside. Ball three. Three balls, one strike. McCormick having a hitch on his left shoulder. Stepped out of the batter's box, reached inside of his shirt and stretched it, which is a very logical thing to do with an hitch. Three balls, one strike. Warnicky winds up, and here it is. Fast ball is fouled back toward the screen. Back into the screen for that matter. Don Tad just started back. No chance for it to get it. It's 3-2. Manager, but fitting him with a very wholesome and hearty original. Cincinnati on first, the second time he's been tapped. That gives Rahm a perfect day at bat with a double and a single. That double by Lombardi was his 26th of the season, and this double by Frank McCormick is 41st. That brings up Harry Kraft. Harry had one hit three times at bat. He singled the left in the second inning. Popped out to short in the third, right out the right field in the fifth. By Wanagi. Here's the pitch to Harry Kraft. He swings, hits the ground ball to short. It's taken by Brown. Brown tosses to Stuart Martin, forcing Lombardi at second, and the side is out. Kraft, Brownie to Brown. Brown tosses to second base to Stuart Martin, forcing Lombardi. Side retired with no run. Two hits. No errors. And two runners are left. Well, there's seven innings of the first game of this doubleheader out of the way. Cincinnati 3, St. Louis Cards 1. Gene Johnson goes out to pick up where he left off with Moore, Martin, and probably somebody to hit for Wanagi as the first three batters. Bob Weiland, W-E-I-L-A-N-D, he fans down Rochester way, we'll remember him, of course. Southpaw, warming up for the Cards. Moore, Martin, and someone to hit for Yeah, the first three batters to come up. Kelly Moore coming up for the fourth time in the game. He grounded out short in the second, walked in the third, walked again in the fifth. That's right-handed. Top of the eighth, Gene Johnson winds up. Here's the pitch. Ground ball right through the box. Out over second into center field. It's a hit. Rolls out to Harry Kraft, who fields it. And Moore is on first with a single. And the eighth hit off Gene Johnson. That brings up Stu Martin. Stu Martin's been up three times, no hits. Moore on first. There's the pitch. He swings at a fastball and misses for strike one. There's the stretch. Next pitch is outside. Again, the stretch by Gene Johnson. Here's the pitch to Martin. He swings and fouls it back off. Umpire Larry gets his chest protector and bounces into the crowd for that. One ball, two strikes. There's the stretch. And here's the pitch. Fastball is hit right in front of the plate, picked out of the air by Lombardi in foul territory and thrown down to first. Lombardi very smartly completing the play. Ball is called foul by umpire Larry Getz. One ball, two strikes is the count. Quick throw to first. Chases Terry Moore back. Inside, ball three. Three balls and no strikes. yards run in the top of the eighth inning with one away.
Fastball, Bugger hits the line drive out for a lefty. Medley comes in, he can't get it. It bounces in front of him.
second, instated by Joe. As it concerns the ball to second, it's a single for Berger. That's his second hit of the afternoon. A single to left. That brings up Billy Myers. Myers gets a great hand. He's played well defensively. And it was his home run that put this game to the point where the Reds are out in front. Manager Bill McKechnie calls to Joe, or Vince DiMaggio, rather, is running for Wally Berger. They're all in the same family. Vince DiMaggio. D-I-N-A-G-G-I-O. charge one, and the heart of the batting order is coming up in the top of the ninth inning. Porter, Medlick, and Mize to face Gene Johnson. Bill Schaffer immediately starts warming up, and Chris DiMaggio, of course, goes to left field in place of Wally Burke. Presenting this broadcast this afternoon over the facilities of the Blue Network of the National Broadcasting Company, direct from Crosley Field. Enos Slaughter, up for the fifth time in the game, has one hit so far in four previous times to that. That was the single to set it back in the first inning. Johnson winds up. There's a pitch. Low. Ball one. One ball, no strike.
Get going, John. While we have time here, umpire Larry Getzko
goes over and asks umpire Bassanelli. Yes, time had been called. And the protest is not allowed. We want to tell you that although we're not going to broadcast the second game of the doubleheader this afternoon on the NBC Blue Network, we're standing by to pick up a celebration in the event the Reds take both ends of the doubleheader this afternoon. And that will be broadcast over some of these stations. We can't tell you the time of that, of course. That's contingent on a lot of things, a lot of gifts in connection with that. So Don Fletcher comes back, and the count is 2-2. Roger Baker, this is the National Broadcasting Company.